60s, and inevitably, perhaps, that is proving very popular. So in this last 2 weeks, Marine Le Pen will go into it with momentum and with a serious chance this time of winning.
All right, James, and we're watching with interest in Paris. Thank you. Sport now, and in Formula One, Ferrari continued their early domination of the new season on the track this morning. Charles Leclerc won the Australian Grand Prix to extend his lead in the championship. World champion Max Verstappen failed to finish because of mechanical problems. Lewis Hamilton finished fourth. The two-time winner this season is now 34 points clear of second-place Brit George Russell in the standings. Finally, it's being billed as a possible Premier League title decider. The top two, Manchester City and Liverpool, are playing each other right now, and it's been just as tight as the battle for the title itself. Chris Scudder reports.
Blue moon, and Man City knew they'd be standing alone and clear at the top if they beat their title rivals here. They could not have dreamt of a better start.
Thiago Jota.
Gabriel Jesus had a titanic tussle at the top. Chris Scudder, ITV News.
Exciting stuff. And that is it for now. I'm back with the late news at 10. Until then, enjoy your evening. Bye-bye.
There'll be some light cloud early on today, but by lunchtime it will almost certainly clear. Heinz Seriously Good Mayonnaise sponsors ITV National Weather.
Hello there, good evening to you. We're going to end the weekend dry for many of us, although some outbreaks of rain affecting parts of Northern Ireland, western parts of Scotland, perhaps even a few spots of rain developing through northern parts of England for a time as well. And with cloudier skies tonight, our temperatures not dropping away quite as chilly as they did last night. So into the start of the new working week, dry and fine for much of Monday morning, but an area of rain pushing up from the southwest. You can see the brighter colours, some of that rain heavy for a time. It moves through Northern Ireland, parts of Wales, northwest England, and through Scotland as well. But elsewhere, staying dry. But you'll notice it will be a windier day tomorrow. But if you're out of the wind, in the sunshine, feeling quite pleasant, warm in the, across England and Wales, highs of 16, 18 degrees Celsius. That warming trend continues through the week as well. But a bit of an unsettled start, some spells of rain initially, but for Easter weekend it's looking quite promising with high pressure building. Have a lovely evening. Bye bye for now.
Heinz Seriously Good Mayonnaise sponsors ITV National Weather.
Business is booming.
That is no reason to rest on our laurels.
By no means. I've learned my lesson from flying too close to the sun. We are most honoured by the invitation, Colonel.
Speculators speculate. That's what you have always said.
Yes, that does sound like me.
Sanditon. New episodes streaming every Monday. Only on BritBox.
Welcome to the concert for Ukraine.
Concert for Ukraine. Support and donate. Watch now on ITV Hub.
Food, fashion, beauty and lifestyle.
We'll bring you sunshine, whatever the weather.
This morning, every weekday from 10 a.m.
I'll leave that one for you to work out, shall I?
For every case...
Stop, please!
There's one solution. Uncover a world of great British crime box sets.
Now we're getting somewhere.
Streaming now on BritBox.
One, two, three.
2 minutes on this show can change your life forever.
Give me that.
Sorry for having an opinion.
Yeah, get off.
Thank you.
amazing.
It was so entertaining.
What?
Non-stop talent, who's next? Britain's Got Talent returns Saturday at 8 on ITV and ITV Hub.
What is more shocking than going to a pop concert and attacking children?
Four of us went to the concert that night and three of us came home. That's not normal.
I did have quite a happy childhood, so I assumed that that was what the world was like.
People have choices. To kill 22 people or not to kill 22 people.
Worlds Collide, the Manchester bombing, tomorrow and Thursday at 9 on ITV and ITV Hub.
Brand new Tipping Point Lucky Stars is on the way after the ITV News where you are.
Hello again, and now the main stories in London. Climate activists have been causing disruption at oil terminals in Hertfordshire and Essex. Some petrol stations in those areas have been forced to turn away motorists because of a lack of fuel. It comes as Extinction Rebellion campaign has shut down Lambeth and Vauxhall bridges, as well as Oxford Street, over the weekend. The campaign group says it's planning protests in the capital every day for the next week. A police officer has been injured by a man wielding a machete in East London. Emergency services were called to Skelton Road in Forest Gate earlier. The injured officer is being treated in hospital for a wound to his arm. London's mayor has thanked the Metropolitan Police Commissioner on her final day in the job. Dame Cresta Dick resigned after Sadiq Khan criticised her handling of racist, homophobic and misogynistic messages shared by a group of officers based at Charing Cross Police Station. Well, today Mr Khan praised her for four decades of dedicated public service. The force's Deputy Commissioner, Sir Stephen Howes, will now take her place, with her permanent successor expected to be appointed this summer. A former soldier reached Hyde Park this afternoon, having completed his mission to run 10 marathons in 100 hours. Well, Darren Hardy suffered multiple fractures and swollen feet during the challenge, but he did it to raise money for a 13-year-old girl who needs life-saving treatment for a rare disease. Aggie Candy Waters was with him as he crossed the finish line. Anna Geary reports.
As a former military man, Darren is no stranger to challenges of extreme endurance. But having run more than 300 kilometres in 100 hours, in Hyde Park this afternoon, he admitted this was his most gruelling test yet.
I'm feeling a bit of a couple of things, really. I'm in absolute agony, pain-wise, but yeah, it's just a relief, really, to finish and, you know, just think what's next, I suppose.
His efforts are in aid of 13-year-old Aggie Candy Waters. She has a rare brain disease known as HABC. It means she can't walk, talk or feed herself, all things she was once able to do. Aggie's mum says it's been an emotional few days following Darren's journey.
His resilience and determination just to help us raise awareness and money for HABC and to find a cure for my daughter is, doing a lot of crying this weekend.
But it wasn't just Ali touched by Darren's action. Frankie too has HABC. His mum says there are medical advances being made in America, but more funding is needed, and it's needed fast.
Literally, the science exists. We now have to get that therapy to a clinical trial to our kids. And every day is a day too late for our kids. Our kids could lose abilities day on day. So we're just fighting now to raise awareness of the disease and to raise funds to help push to a clinical trial.
Meanwhile, Darren's trial has raised more than £30,000. He's been told it will take his body more than half a year to recover. But there's no stopping him.
Get in the gym and train the upper legs. They've taken a bit of a battering, so biceps and chest for the next 6 months, I think, and some triceps in there, so really, yeah.
Darren vows to keep going, to improve life for young children like Aggie and their families. Anna Geary, ITV News, Hyde Park.
All right, time to take a look at the day's sport now.
Sport.
Small businesses and local teams, the heart of our communities. eBay sponsors ITV Regional Sport Reports.
In the Premier League, Brentford continued their resurgent form by beating West Ham United 2-0 at home. Meanwhile, Crystal Palace lost 2-1 away to Leicester City. And Lewis Hamilton is now 43 points behind Charles Leclerc following the Ferrari driver's victory at the Australian Grand Prix. The Stevenage sports star started in fifth and finished fourth, but says he's staying optimistic for an eighth title win with 20 races to go. It's time for the weather now. Here's James with the forecast.
Feels like home, whatever the weather. Valent Boilers and Heat Pumps sponsors ITV London Weekend Weather.
Hello, good evening. A bit of a chilly, frosty start for many places this morning. Don't think we'll see any frost over the next few nights, though, because the air mass is starting to change. Much milder air moving up from the south, but you can also see plenty of low pressure and you can see plenty of fronts indicating it's going to be rather unsettled at times as we head towards Easter. As far as tonight goes, not a great deal happening. Fairly light breezes, bits of cloud drifting through, a dry night and a frost-free one. Temperatures way up on where we saw last night, with lows of around 5 to 8 Celsius. And it sets us up for a pretty decent start to the week. Some good bright spells breaking to proper sunshine for a while. But you'll notice the big white arrows developing. That's a sign that things are getting a little bit windier as we head through the day, a little bit blustery. But if you can stay in the bright or sunny spells, stay out of the breeze, you'll get maybe 17, 18 Celsius, so several degrees up on where you'd expect at this time of year. A rather wet start to the day on Tuesday. This is about 6 in the morning, but once that clears, things turn a little bit showery and breezy, but highs of 18, possibly warmer still on Wednesday.
Valent sponsors ITV London Weekend Weather.
That is all from the London team for now. We are back tomorrow with updates starting in Good Morning Britain from 6 a.m. Until then, have a very good evening. Bye-bye.
The man spoke his last words to you. That's a bond.
Why didn't they ask Evans?
What does that mean?
I don't know.
I'm trying to work out what had happened.
How exciting.
You caused quite a stir in the village.
That's how I like my villagers.
Did you say someone tried to poison me?
Do you mean to tell me that you cannot remember?
I'm not going to hurt you.
She's pretty.
She's frightened.
She's pretty frightened.
Why didn't they ask Evans? Streaming Thursday, only on BritBox.
Technology.
Tenants.
Democracy.
Deterrent.
Protesters.
Party.
Crown.
Congress.
Volunteers.
Ventilators.
Rebellions. Refugees.
Civilians.
Safety.
Independent.
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 You have our word.
Independent news is what we stand for.
Which letter of the alphabet is used most often in this question? James, where are you from?
Newcastle.
Oh, surprised you didn't go for Y or I.
Are you smart enough to be in the 1% Club? Join Lee Mack, Saturday at 9.25 on ITV and ITV Hub.
Oti Mabuse is the ultimate musical matchmaker in a hot new dating show.
Welcome to Romeo and Duet.
My heart goes.
We're going to be sending 4 gorgeous singles up to our flinging balcony.
Minnie can't see over that.
However, our singletons will only have the voice and song choice to go on. Will the next singer succeed where others have failed?
Make a date with Romeo and Duet, Saturday at 7 on ITV and ITV Hub.
I was so scared. I thought he was gonna kill me. Nailed it.
So you framed her, for your daughter's death is revenge because she ended your affair. Is that correct?
I would never lie about Mina's confession.
Despite having other reasons to seek revenge.
Poor sis. I really felt for her.
She cannot get away with this.
Will this be Mina's final performance? Emmerdale, next week on ITV and ITV Hub.
I'm going to fake my death.
Where have you decided to live when it's all calmed down?
Next door!
An unbelievably true story.
worst is over now, pet. I promise you.
The Thief, His Wife and the Canoe starts Easter Sunday at 9 on ITV and ITV Hub.
Ben Shepherd's here now on ITV as more celebs face the machine. On brand new Tipping Point, Lucky Stars.
Like sleeping under your lucky stars, Otti Hybrid Mattress sponsors Tipping Point, Lucky Stars.